Hello everybody, I'm Thelastarcadegamer. Now, I know there was some recording issues the last time. Again, as I said, I don't have the best mic. Really, it's just earbuds with a microphone in it that I have plugged into my controller. That's all my mic is. So I'm still trying to learn the optimum place to put it. So if there's any more audio issues, especially with S's, T's, D's, B's, P's, stuff like that, I'm sorry. I don't have much control over that. I understand, I could edit that, but I don't know how. I'm not that kind of person. I'm not that technologically advanced. When it comes to games, I play them. I can record them. I'm not going to edit them. Why? Two reasons. First, I'm a console gamer. Second, I don't really know how to edit stuff on computers. Same group as last time. I still have Dotto and Letty. I could use them. I could not use them. I don't think I ever will use them. Tex, I don't need to worry about. Jamal, can you learn grip gloves? No. Of course, that's right, we're going against Ronsos. I need him to learn grip gloves really badly. I don't know why I gave him golden arm. I guess I didn't know what it did. It sounded like something for a goalie, because I saw a goalie have it. Jasu! And now we pass to Bada, or Boda, or however your name is pronounced. You catch it, you swim. That's right, it's Ronsos, they're slow. Why am I worried about getting caught by them? Biggs has no chance of getting it in the goal, so I only have to, I can only rely on Tidus. Okay. I doubt I'm making it past their attack. If my predictions are correct, because of how much I've played Blitzball, they got special tackles equipped. So if I tried to break through one or the other, their attack would probably be high enough to steal the ball. I wish they had some form of commentary for Blitzball matches, like they did for the actual tournament, you know, your first Blitzball match that you play. Now granted, there's no actual commentary while you're playing it, but there is commentary at, like, halftime, after the game, before the game, and there's commentary during the game when Waka is playing against the Albed. So, I guess there is commentary going on, it's just we can't hear it because we're in a giant sphere made out of water. He has 6 shots. He can't be the striker. You can't be. You have no chance. Oh yes. Thank you. That helps a lot. Do I want to? Venom Shot raises it what? Not Venom Shot. Venom Sack raises it 5? Which would tie her with me, giving her a decent chance to steal it. Let's hope for the best, hope she has nothing, and then we'll shoot. Of course. That only raised it by 3 though, so not too bad. I love Tidus. He's just the best striker that I know of. Now I have the guidebook. I could look in there to see what the best striker is. For all I know, it could be Waka. But Tidus is just, he's the best that I know of. We're not gonna break him, are we? No. No, we're not. Biggs has a higher attack than him? Than Tidus? Oh god, that's what that does. Ooh, you're extremely slow. You got 14 shot though, so I guess you compensate for it. You got it? Ooh. Oh no, Tidus is asleep. Jasu, and then we pass it to Biggs and hope he can goal. Or we pass it to Biggs and hope he's fast enough to avoid the Ronsos. Crap. If we give it to Biggs, we can have him swim around for a bit, and I know that's going to be boring. But if my theory is correct, he will gain a lot of experience for it. He's pretty fast enough to avoid them. That's nice. Now, I could pass the ball to Tidus in order to wake him up. The problem is, then the ball rebounds, and then I don't know who's going to get it. We have a minute. Tidus woke up. There is a slight possibility that Biggs could get a goal in the last 30 seconds, if he doesn't get screwed over by the Ronsos. Oh no. Oh no. Oh no no, this is not good. This isn't good at all. This isn't good at all. I mean, it's practically halftime anyway, so we have nothing to worry about. We're not going to break her. Oh, we might. We did. He only has 4 shot, though. So, we pass to Tidus. Yeah, we're not making another goal. No, we're not. I was hoping to get one last goal in. Blitzball matches seem so long when you're playing them, and part of that is the fact that when you open up that little menu, time stops. Nice. That's good. But another part of the fact is that you get immersed into it. And then it's only at the points where you want there to be more time that the time runs out. Like when you're making shots, when you're making passes, well not necessarily passes, just when you're making shots is when the time runs out and you don't want it to run out. I mean, I guess during passes because pass it to somebody and they can shoot. I understand where they went with this is you have the ball, the timer counts down. The ball is moving through the water, the timer counts down. What I would really like is if, say, I know this isn't logical, but if, say, time stopped unless a character was holding the ball. If a character had the ball and they were moving, then time continued. Please, don't catch it. Don't get a hand on it. She got a hand on it. If she hadn't gotten a hand on that, we would have had... Biggs might have gotten it in. Oh, no. We're not taking this. If Tidus is the one attacking, forget about it. He's not getting it. At least we have Jasu. We have a chance. Go with Venom. Venom looks nice. She's poison! Huzzah! Okay, Biggs, here's the plan. You're gonna be swimming for a little bit. It's gonna be boring. You're gonna bypass the Ronsos, you're gonna get to their goal, and you're going to score a goal. How's that sound? Hopefully, you scoring a goal is going to make you level up more. Sadly, you're just a little bit faster than a Ronso, so this gets very tedious. Of course, that one's moving to the corner. Damn it! It's possible. No, it's not. Stop blocking him! I want him to level up. I know you don't, but I do. How did Jasu not get a hand on that?
Normally it's Tidus.
And we have no chance. All our chances of breaking this guy are out of here. Jasu, twice in a row, you are fucked up. What's wrong with you today? Yes, he fumbles. Tidus? Biggs? No, it's a Ronso. Is it a bird? It's a plane. No, it's a giant lion creature that has a horn. Oh no. Wait, if you're breaking through both of us, why are you not passing? You have a high enough pass as it is.
Oh. Oh, okay.
Jasu only has 17 endurance. Okay, we have less than a minute. Oh Lord Biggs, move it! Move your slow ass! Yes! I hope he's gonna level up now. And with 5 seconds left to go, they should just forfeit. Five seconds! He doesn't even have time to start swimming. Do they just start heading towards the exit? I think the losers go and head towards the exit when time's up, while the winners just go and swim in circles. He only got 4 experience. Biggs only got 4 experience. Why? What is the mystery to the leveling system, to the experience system in Blitzball? I don't get it. What makes them level up? Apparently it's not having the ball. I mean, it may be tackles. Or something related to that man. We're doing what's best suited for you. And Tidus, I don't understand how he didn't get any experience, because he scored what, twice? So he should have gotten experience for that. Zalots and Bada didn't level up, I don't know why. So I don't really get this. I don't get the leveling system. Lotto expired? They rehired. How did Tidus not get any experience for that? The owl bed tied with Killica? How? I mean, I understand they put up a decent fight. Owl bed. Oh my god. We're the only ones who won. This is going great. Everybody else tied. But how did the owl bed tie with a normal human team? Then again, the Killica did hire a freelance, but still, the Albed are just so strong, it shouldn't matter. It was all Volusia. Well, I'd love it. So we're leading the league. That's good. I'm not using you, I think. Fuck, I don't remember. I should be paying attention. No, I'm not. No, you did not, Dado. You did not become good. You did not. I didn't use you. At all. I mean, I understand there's sentimental value to keeping the original not Albed Sykes, the original Besaid Aurochs. But they aren't the best team. Especially when leveling up. That's where the free agents succeed. The problem with the free agents is they start at level 1. So if you eventually get to the point where you find somebody who's going to become the best goalie in the game, but you've played Blitzball dozens, if not hundreds of times by that point, it's going to be very difficult to level that person up, especially if they're a goalie. And you don't want to place them in the goalie spot, because then they're going against strikers who are at, say, level 82. Level 1 goalie versus a level 82 striker is not going to end well. It's not. Which is why I saved playing Blitzball until I hired a few free agents. I got Zalitz, I got Biggs, though I didn't really want Biggs. In fact, I'm thinking about dropping Biggs. And, Jamal, that's the other one. I hired Jamal. I think I said this in the last one. I've got the book for Final Fantasy X, so I know which people are free agents and whatnot, but I don't look at the end of their levels to see which one is the best. I don't look at each free agent and say, oh, this guy is going to become the best goalkeeper out of anybody else. I'm going to go get him. I don't do that. I just go with what I have. And then I think at some point the other teams go, and their members, their teammates start leveling up. And I think that just gets so costly that they let them go, and they hire free agents. Like him, he's level 9. He's only 80 gil. Okay, so maybe not. I thought maybe when they leveled up, the amount of gil they needed to be rehired leveled up. I'd be correct. But Jamal, his salary is 200 gil per game. And when I looked at his stats, and the highest stat in level 1 is his catching stat, well then that's immediately saying, hey, this guy is a good goalkeeper. He cost 200 gil, that's quite expensive, have you, and his highest stat is catching. And compared to the few others that I was browsing at, he's got good catch, especially when compared to Keepa. And I think there's a twist with the, with a free agent, is that I think he starts off as one of the best strikers, and when he gets to level 99, he's the best goalie. So it's like kind of ironic in a sense. And I know I'm kind of monologuing here, and it's kind of boring because I'm just standing still. But I really just want to play Blitzball. That's all I want to do. I just love Blitzball so much. 3 stars? What is that? And a return sphere? Damn, that sounds nice. I know I'm monologuing. I know that was boring for people who don't like monologuing. And I know I'm monologuing now, but I'm just talking about the game. I'm talking about Blitzball. I'm talking about the free agents and stuff like that. Stuff related to Blitzball. And there's somebody watching this that just wants to watch Blitzball or watch stuff about Blitzball. And not the Blitzball with the bat and the baseball. I mean, Final Fantasy Blitzball. Then they may not get so bored. They may be listening to what my opinions are. They may agree with me. They may disagree. That's up to them. They may stay neutral. They may not give a shit. Who knows? And that, as I say, is that. I should have went and talked to the history man there. He could have done that for me. I'm going to stop it here. Next time we come back, we will be going against the Killica Beasts again. Varora, or whatever his name is. I don't like him. He's pretty good, which is why I don't like him. I don't like him because he's not on my side. Oh god, I better stop now while I'm ahead.